In this video, I'm going to share with you foods to eliminate and foods to include according to our Reawaken Healing Cleanse. And by the way, my name is Amrita Ma Devi, and I'm an Ayurvedic health coach and practitioner online, author and mama of three. I help women balance their weight and their hormones, run bi-yearly cleanses, retreats and workshops. This is my YouTube channel for newbies and lovers of Ayurveda. And if you haven't already, subscribe to our channel. Today's video is going over the foods we ask to eliminate in our 10-day cleanse. And there are many foods that can wreak havoc on one's digestive system and create long-term health issues. And a cleanse is a perfect invitation to support your body by eating less. But this doesn't mean that you're cutting out a variety of foods in your diet. This just simply means that you're simplifying your diet, and it feels like a breath of fresh air for your body, mind, and soul. As you burn up toxins so that you can reduce accumulation and feel lighter as you move into the second part of the year, making a recalibration really balances out the body. I have done many cleanses in my life, and they provide you with an opportunity to tune into what is essential in your diet as nourishment and what is more of a treat. And we don't deprive ourselves of flavor and content. We have 50 recipes in our Ayurvedic meal plan for each dosha, and they're easy to follow. It's our three-step guide for you to get success with your cleansing. How to get the maximum results from your cleanse? Well, let's eliminate these foods. Starting with dairy. Dairy contains whey and casein proteins. Pasteurized milk is void of the enzymes needed to break down these proteins, making it incredibly hard on your body. A2 cow's milk is different, however, and is well tolerated. Lactose intolerance occurs due to the deficiency in lactase enzyme and causes symptoms such as gas, bloating, and diarrhea, which causes your gut bacteria to ferment these lactose sugars. Lactose intolerance is a food sensitivity, and it affects you almost immediately. It causes about 70% of people around the globe that don't even have these enzymes to digest lactose. Gluten. Eliminating bleached and refined flours. Gluten is a wheat protein that gives bread products their chewiness and their texture. And gluten is made up of two different types of proteins, the glutenane and the gliadin. So why are more people affected than ever? Well, wheat products are today contain 30 to 40% more gluten than the wheat products our ancestors ate. This is predominantly due to the crop, how it's changed over the years. Glutenin is responsible for the strength and the elasticity of dough. This is also similar to the structure of the thyroid protein, so your body gets confused. If you have Hashimoto's disease or Graves' disease, both autoimmune diseases, eating gluten will cause your body to also attack your thyroid gland. It will increase weight gain, fatigue, brain fog, skin rashes, cause constipation. These are some of the signs of this sensitivity. And most people have no idea they have this sensitivity to gluten. So each time you eat gluten, it has an impact on your body for about 6 months. The best thing to do is to help your body and cut this out. Eliminate gluten from your diet for 10 days and see how you feel. More than 90% of soy grown in the US is GMO. This GMO soy interferes with the absorption of essential minerals such as selenium, which helps convert primary thyroid hormone T4 to its active form of T3. Corn, the outer shells of nuts, also contain phytates. Lectins bind to the cell lining of your intestine, disrupting the tight junctions that allow partially digested food to get through it. Once absorbed, lectins attach to many tissues, causing white blood cells to trigger an autoimmune response. Lectins block insulin receptors, which creates insulin resistance, ultimately leading to weight gain, obesity, and diabetes. Phytates interfere with the absorption of important minerals such as calcium, iron, magnesium, copper, and zinc. Egg yolks are high in arachidonic acid. We abbreviate that to AA, a pro-inflammatory omega-6 fatty acid. Most eggs also come from chickens fed on a diet of GMO soy and corn. Remember, it's not also what we eat, but also what we eat eats. So organic eggs from cage-free hens are much healthier, of course, because they're fed a natural diet. Free-range diets rich in omega-3s are allowed after the elimination phase of part of our diet. Nightshade vegetables, tomatoes, eggplants, peppers, and potatoes, bell peppers, pepinos, tomillos, sweet and hot peppers, and pimientos. Plants in this family produce alkaloids, a natural insect repellent that can be damaging to humans if eaten in high quantities. Cooking these plants lowers the quality of alkaloid content by about 40-50%, but we're still going to reduce these in our diet. They contain lectins and sugar-binding proteins, which overactivate our immune system and cause pain and inflammation in the body. And if anyone has rheumatoid arthritis or autoimmune disease or pain conditions, it's recommended that you avoid these foods completely in our 10-day cleanse. Sugar plays a role in most diseases and acts like an addiction when one has a very toxic body. The result is an addiction which plays with your mood and your emotions, and when your blood sugar drops, you get irritable, you feel drowsy and perhaps slightly headachy, or you feel a pressure in your sinuses. If you are particularly toxic, you can feel the effects in your muscles and your joints. After a few hours of eating some high sugar, your body releases cortisol to balance the insulin from the sugar that you've just eaten. High cortisol, which is the stress hormone, it also impacts on the adrenal glands and makes you feel wound up and unsettled, ready for your next dose of sugar. Sugar is like a drug. In fact, it lights up the same reward pathways in the brain as cocaine does. And the more you do, the harder you fall, crash, and dip. Refined cane sugar, high fructose corn syrup, and any other sweetening derivative can cause these top 10 problems. Unsustainable source of energy and devoid of nutrients, minerals, vitamins, and essential fatty acids. It's linked to a decreased intake in essential nutrients. High in fructose, which is metabolized fully in the liver, does not turn off the hunger signals, ghrelin. To avoid sugar can lead to a fatty liver, causes insulin resistance, causes inflammation, and inflammation causes pain. It's linked to an increase in body weight. Highly addictive because it triggers the release of dopamine, the pleasure hormone in the brain. Feeds cancer, raises your cholesterol. Do ask yourself if you reward yourself with sugar. Did your parents reward you as a child with sugar? If that's the case, it's not your fault. You know it's the most addictive substance that is commonly used, and knowledge is power. Alcohol and caffeine. Alcohol is a very drying substance and it's toxic to the body. The internet is full of mixed messages about alcohol. On the one hand, a moderate amount have linked to health benefits. On the other hand, it's addictive and highly toxic, especially when you drink too much. The truth is that the health benefits of alcohol vary between individuals and depends on the amount and type of alcohol consumed. Much is the same about coffee, that for some people it works and for others it doesn't. In Ayurveda, these substances are really drying for the body and heating. Fresh fruit, a variety of fruit in moderation. Tubers, sweet potatoes, taro, yam, as well as psyllium, artichokes. Fermented probiotic rich foods, such as miso paste. Minimally processed vegetable oils such as olive oil, avocado oil, and coconut oil. Herbs and spices, as long as they're derived from a seed and we can grind them ourselves. Natural sweeteners such as maple syrup and honey in moderation. Certain teas such as green teas and herbal teas. We recommend you take 3 or 4 cups a day. Mineral plant-based broth, which I can't wait to share with you my plant-based recipe. The Reawaken Healing Cleanse focuses on clean ingredients, foods which are easy to digest, low in fructose and sugar, and devoid of things that are hard on your gut. The emphasis is on foods that are organic, pesticide-free, non-GMO, full of healthy fats, locally grown and sustainably farmed. If you feel called to join us, then come aboard. We start on the 22nd of September, folks, and you can find more information on the Ayurveda Anytime Instagram account and website. I look forward to welcoming you there soon.